Erica.
Ew.
You
have been.
You are hereby issued.
A strike.
A dead strike.
A strong and final warning.
Ew, thank God.
Kid Wire, for flipping your finger to the camera on a second occasion, you are hereby issued a strike.
Erica. At this point, Erica needs to be put on a table and given like 50 strokes of cane. Let me just summarize everything that happened because the live show is about to start. So Erica and Kid Wire decided to do this to Big Brother. Like, never in the history of Big Brother has this ever happened. You guys understanding Erica, people are trying, you know. Because by now, she would have given you chest pain every day. You're like worrying about one thing or the other. Now, she's already at the edge of a cliff and she's about to fall. And she's still like doing things. Like, who does that? Who really, really does that? She's very, very lucky today because normally she's supposed to get like a strike. But, you know, maybe Big Brother is not ready to disqualify them yet. She's just like, okay, let me just leave them because these people are bringing content and stuff. Last time when they gave her strikes, like the two strikes, she was still there being, like, she did not look like somebody that they just gave punishment for something. She even went as far as saying, my this thing is their entertainment. Whether my misbehavior is their entertainment or my this is their entertainment. Like, what kind of entertainment is that? Entertainment that's going to take you home? You want to come and entertain us from your house or what? And it was that same day that they decided to do this to Big Brother after the strike. Big Brother said he decided to let it slide because, okay, he just gave them punishment. So let me just leave this one. And they had the mind, the head of house lounge. Because you're in head of house lounge, you think you can do anyhow. They had the mind to do this. You're following billionaire's son to misbehave. If he comes out, definitely it's going to pain him because nobody wants to like be disqualified from a show like that. It's better let them vote you out because it's shameful to like be among those that will be disqualified. It's as if every year they used to disqualify somebody. You'll now be the one to be disqualified. Nobody wants that, but he's going to do very well. And you know this, Erica knows this, that oh, the guy is doing very well and you decide to now join him to do this kind of thing, especially when you have two strikes. You're on the edge already and then you're doing, see, I'm just like, don't understand. That guy has coconut head. Kid Wire too has coconut head, but her own coconut is very, very strong. So apparently, Kid Wire did that again to Big Brother another day. He was just there. I don't know. I don't know whether he was joking. You know, Kid Wire likes to just do nonsense sometimes. He likes to use cuss words anyhow. So this time around, he just like did to Big Brother like this. Like, I'm like, okay. So the second time he did, Kid Wire's one was two times that he did. I don't want to say it because, you know, the way YouTube is, sometimes they can just decide to flag your channel because you're using like cuss words and stuff. So I'm just going to be using this as my way of explaining what happened. You and I know what this is all about. So Kid Wire got a strike for doing that to Big Brother twice. He got a strike. Erica got a final warning. This is the second time Big Brother is giving them final warning. He already gave them final warning before when they were having plenty fights in the house. Then he now gave Erica two strikes. So which one is final warning again? If you're looking at it critically, there are some of people in the house by now that should have gone home, but Big Brother is just being very lenient with them. If they like, they should not correct their brain. So now Erica and Kid Wire, they're on the same level. After the gathering in the lounge, Kid Wire and Erica, they now went outside to talk. Kid Wire was now saying that he needs to go and read the rule book again because the way it is now, anything can just bring a strike, that he has to be extra careful now. Erica was just there trying to, at first she was even trying to like defend herself. She was now saying, okay, the first time it happened, she knows they were drunk and stuff. Kid Wire now told her that that kind of thing, you should not even be doing that kind of thing. That doesn't make any sense. Like, he just accepted that it was very, very wrong of him to do that kind of thing. That right now, he doesn't want to be disqualified. That it's better for him to be voted out than for him to be disqualified. Then you now go out and be saying, what if this might have happened? It's better you know that, okay, your fans were not strong enough than for you to come out and be like regretting and stuff. So they just had discussed it. Meanwhile, during the meeting, during the gathering at the lounge, Big Brother announced to Prince and Nengi that they won an all expense paid VVIP trip to Dubai, to the One African Music Fest Dubai. I already posted about it when they talked about it on their Twitter handle, but now Biggie has announced to them. I'm so happy that they know about it. You know that Prince was very, very, very sad that day, so now he was like so happy. Him and Nengi just hugged, like, as in, you know, when the happiness enter your head that you forget that, oh, maybe I and this person were not so close. So they also won 250,000 naira each. So they are 250,000 naira richer. See, it's good to be sad when you lose because I'm sure if they were not so sad like that, Pepsi would have not even answered them. But Prince was just on about it, sulking, and they're like, okay, what's 250k now? Let's just give them something. So that's how they got this money and this trip. So Ozo and Nengi, they have an all expense paid trip to Dubai because Ozo won the main Pepsi game, and now Nengi, so all of them go to Dubai. Ozo, Nengi, Chikiti and Prince. It's gonna be a fun trip to Dubai. So let me just, because the live show is going to begin very soon. I just said, let me come and talk to you about Erica's coconut head. You guys should, if you're her village people, or if you're her stan, just gather and start praying for her, because at this point, I don't know what to say. If you're still here to this point, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and I'm going to see you guys very, very soon. Like, I'm going to post a video after the live show. So, bye guys. Love you.